In this video, I will show you the results of replanting these aloe vera pups in three different soil types. Welcome to the aloe vera garden. I have tried many soil types in the garden, but I have not compared the results. This is the first time. These were the soils that were used in this video. The first one is the soil I got from the compost. My compost is a mixture of discarded soil, grass cuttings including aloe vera, and kitchen scraps. The second one I got from the discarded plant soil. I am labeling this reused soil as ordinary soil because there probably aren't many nutrients left. The third one is also a reused soil, but I added cow manure. I just eyeballed how much cow manure was added. It is probably about 20% to my estimate. These are the six aloe vera plants that I used, two plants for each type of soil. These plants were placed in full sun, which explains the form and color of their leaves. It was also a challenge to pick plants that are equal when it comes to size and health. I selected what I thought were healthier and bigger to be planted in the reused soil to give it a growth advantage. While the rest were for the two other types of soils that I thought had more nutrients. This is how I replant aloe vera. The roots may take a few weeks to grow to the new soil added. I repotted this plant with exposed roots using soil with cow manure. It is also a little smaller compared to the others. Also, I made sure that the exposed roots were covered with soil. You may have noticed that the soil covers beyond the oldest leaf or the leaves at the bottom. In my previous video on how to plant aloe vera, I said that the soil should not go beyond the bottom leaves. This is because I did not press down the soil hard. After all, it will eventually go lower after watering. I always water plants after repotting, especially since the soil of these plants was very dry. The following day, I placed white plastic markers to ensure I would not get lost in which spot has the type of soil. The plants showed no significant difference after 3 weeks, except that they began to look greener. This can also be attributed to their being placed in a partially shaded area. The garden is already full and I can't find a place in full sun that is safe from stray cats. Stray cats sometimes fight at night in the garden and destroy some plants, particularly plants in small pots like these. These are the plants after 3 months. If you don't look closely, they are similar. As I mentioned in my previous videos, aloe vera requires minimal soil nutrients to grow, especially when young. That is why even those planted in reused soil have grown well. The only difference I can see if I look closely is that those planted in reused soil have lighter green leaves than others. This aloe vera plant in compost soil has darker green color than those sown in reused soil. The plants in soil with cow manure added also have darker green color but are a little bigger than the others. Based on my experience planting aloe vera in pots, soil matters only when they are big and the roots have almost saturated the whole pot. This explains why pups planted in pure sand, as shown in my previous videos, look fine when young but not when they grow bigger in pots. I hope you learned something from this video. This is Danny. Thank you for watching and God bless.